Good morning, everyone. This is Sean with the Disney Pinholics. Just wanted to do a quick video here about pin trading online or selling online. Now, when you pin trade online, there are some traditional rules that need to be followed. First being, you should definitely take good pictures of your pins. And when I say good pictures, I'm talking about very clear pictures of the pins. Make sure there's no glare on the picture or anything like that, and make sure it's cleared and zoomed in. Very important, because when you're dealing with Disney pins, unfortunately there are a lot of fake pins out there, and people need to be able to see good images of your pins to ensure that they are either purchasing or trading authentic pins. So it's very important that you do take good pictures of your pins. Now, it's also suggested to go ahead and take pictures of the back of your pins. Make sure that, again, the pictures are very clear and precise and zoomed in. Very important. Now, there are ways of doing this online. Now, people will sometimes purchase pins outright, and, you know, you get a price, you like the price, you buy them. That's good. However, it's very, very much suggested to do your homework on the pins before you purchase them. There are some people that will get as much as they can for their pins, and if you do not do your homework ahead of time, you could be typically paying anything upwards. I've seen in some cases 3 to 4 times the amount what the going rate of that pin is. So it's suggested to check eBay for the sale of the pins. We on the Disney Pinholics like using a 30 day window of the sales of the pins. That way we can see on there what has happened on those pins within the last 30 days, and we use that as a fair value to allow it to be posted on the group. So do your homework on the sales of pins on eBay. That's a good start. Go ahead and check that out. Make sure that what you are paying is what you should be paying. Very important. Same thing goes for opportunity drawings. Make sure that the number of spots equal what the values of those pins would be. And if they're not, you know, it's up to you whether or not you want to pay, you know, an insane amount for those pins. So again, do your homework on those pins and make sure that you're not getting ripped off. The same goes for if you're trading. Make sure that what you're trading for is a fair value for what you're getting. Now again, it's up to you whether or not, you know, you want to make it a better trade for the person you're dealing with, and that's completely up to you. I personally like to do my homework and make sure that the trade is fair on both sides. If I feel that what I'm offering to them is a good trade, and if they are okay with the trade, and if they do their homework and they trade me what they feel is okay, that's okay. If not, it's okay to speak up and say, oh, you know, I really don't think that's a fair trade. And again, use eBay sold values is a good way to start to make sure you check the prices on that. So that's a good start. And that brings me to another point regarding if a trade does not work out. Please, if you are trading with somebody and maybe they may not have pins of equal value or pins that you may not collect, but when somebody comes to you for a trade, and if they do not have pins that you would be interested in, please just say, I'm sorry, but the pins that you are offering me isn't anything I would collect at this time, but thank you very much for sharing them with me. Little things like that definitely helps people, and definitely helps people understand that they're not rude people. You know, we have our collections that we like, and there's nothing wrong with you know, people collecting little, hidden Mickeys, for example, compared to people that collect the high-end limited editions. And that's okay. But when a trade does not happen and how we conduct ourselves together, that's what determines whether or not people will even want to trade again. And us as traders, I believe, really need to work together and not be rude. I've seen so many times people have said rudely to the other people, oh, your pins aren't as valuable as mine. That is a completely rude statement. And that is a statement that will not be tolerated in a Disney Pinholics. No matter what page you're on, no matter where you are with our groups, if that ever happens, you need to bring that to a admin's attention, and we will handle that accordingly. So again, if it does not work out in a trade, that's okay. It's okay to say, I'm sorry, but what you're offering me isn't what I would collect, but thank you for sharing. And there's absolutely nothing wrong with that statement. But again, it's how it's being said, and make sure that it's not being rude or disrespectful. Now, also when you are trading or you are selling, it's very important that you package your pins accordingly. And what I mean by that is using a bubble mailer with bubble wrap. Ideally, bubble wrap is the preferred method. However, there are many different other ways you can wrap pins to make sure that they do not get damaged. And ultimately, that is what we want. We want to make sure that the pins do not get damaged when they are being shipped. That's why bubble wrap is the preferred method, because it gives the added protection. Now, there are some people that will use foam, or they'll use, I've even seen people use park maps as their way of packaging the pins. And I'm not saying it's wrong, as long as the pin is being properly packaged and it does not get damaged in shipping, I'm okay with it. But again, the bubble mailers and the bubble wrap is the ideal way. But again, as long as the pin does not get damaged, we're okay with it. So, but again, make sure that you do that. You can also save costs in shipping if you already have a PayPal. If you go to paypal.com/shipnow, you will be able to print your own tracking online, be able to print out your own barcode and print it out and put it on your package. And it'll save you a couple bucks sometimes, and you will be able to take care of your own shipping, and all you got to do is just bring it to the post office. And that's a good way to save yourself a little bit of money. But that's all I have for today. Again, I just wanted to continue with these educational videos. I'm not an expert by any stretch of the imagination. I just want to share the information that I do know. And I wanted to help everyone with pin trading. Pin trading is an absolutely amazing hobby. My family and I love it. We've met some really wonderful people pin trading, and it's a great way to be able to talk to one another and get to know one another and have a good time. So again, everyone, thank you very much for tuning in. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'll do my best to post some more videos soon. And as always, thank you very much for choosing Disney Pinholics. I hope you have a great rest of your day.